Okay, so today I have Miss Anita, and she's an RTX fashion designer. How are you doing today, Miss Anita?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. Would you like to introduce yourself?
Sure. All right, so as you said, I'm a ready-to-wear fashion designer. My name is Anita. I started fashion, well, basically since I was a child. It's really in my family. It's a generational thing. And my brand, Naomi Avec Amour, it's more of a homage to three specific women in my life. My mom, my grandmother, my aunt, who passed away. And I decided to really name the brand of my aunt. So the name Naomi is actually her name, and Avec Amour, it's French for with love. So everything I do, basically every skirt that I make, every dress that I make, everything I do with love. So that's really the reason behind the name. I studied fashion in college at the Edna Manley College. Currently, now I'm a teacher, where I teach students or adults with special needs to do textiles. A few of them also know how to do sewing, so I kind of, you know, help them along the way with that. It's a really good thing in terms of, you know, helping people. That's something that I always wanted to do. So any knowledge that I have, you can always come to me, you can always ask me. And I'm not the type of person to turn anyone away. If it is that I know what the answer is, definitely I'll help. If I don't know, Google is my best friend, so is YouTube and Wikipedia. So that's really who Anita is, basically.
Absolutely. So Miss Anita, my first question for you is, what is your zodiac sign?
Taurus. I am a bull.
Say that one more time.
I am a bull, Taurus.
Oh, a Taurus. That's cool. That's cool. What do they say about Tauruses?
Oh, we're stubborn. We're mean. We are very loving people. That much I can say. That's very true. I don't know. We're short-tempered. We have a lot of attitude. But I don't really associate myself with just a sign. I am who I am. People are who they are. So I don't really associate anybody with their sign. If I say, oh, that's how Scorpios are, I don't believe in that. But sometimes, you know, they do associate themselves with their sign. So.
Absolutely. I understand. My next question for you, Miss Anita, is what's your favorite color? Do you have a favorite number?
7.
That's my favorite number too. I don't know. I think my favorite 7. What are your 5 favorite foods?
Oh, I can't saltfish, breadfruit, jerk chicken, jerk pork, the KFC phone?
Yes, ma'am. Oh, absolutely. That's okay. My next question for you is, what are your 5 favorite restaurants? You can say KFC again if you want.
Okay. KFC. Wendy's. There is a place in Jamaica called Pizza Please, where they basically explore different ways to make pizza. If you get here, you have to try it. Like, definitely. Every other corner shop that has loaded fries. How much is that? KFC, Burger King, Pizza Please, every corner shop that has loaded fries, and Starbucks. their coffee is amazing.
That's cool. What 5 countries would you like to visit?
Definitely Africa. Like, that's my number one, definitely. Then there's Paris, because that is one of the fashion go-to places. Then there's New York, there's Florida, and England, because I love football.
That's cool. Would you rather go into space or deep sea diving?
Space, because I'm afraid of drowning.
Me too. What would you like to see in space?
Oh, just the moon. The thing about being a night person is just the calmness and the stillness. And because I'm like an owl, because that's my favorite animal, or bird, I should say. There's just so much stillness in the night, and that's the best time for me to do the work. That's the best time that my brain is really active in the night. I think that's something that I actually got from college, because mainly that's the only time that we work. In the day, it's just everybody up and down, and the night is just so peaceful, and it's just still, and your brain is just winding like a clock. So that's really, it would be the moon and the stars, and it's just a peace there.
Yes, ma'am. What are your 5 favorite animals?
The owl, the turtle, the dolphin. That point of that animal. Even though it's a mama.
It's okay.
Dog and rabbit. I hate cats.
Me too.
I hate cats.
Yeah, me too. They scratch you too much. I don't like that.
Wow, steal a lot. They're conniving.
For real, they mean. And then people who own them, they like, oh, it's okay. I'm used to it. Like, what? What you mean? No. You better go beat that. Like, let my dog scratch me. No. He won't scratch me again.
There you go.
But a cat, they their own person. Mm-hmm. They gonna do what they want. It's cool, though. It's cool. Do you have any pets?
I had one, but, you know, here's the thing in Jamaica. When you have dogs, people are so quick to kill them. I don't know why. Like, I really don't know why. I guess they can't start barking. I just don't know why. But I had a dog. His name was George. And he wasn't a bad dog, like, to, you know, brush people or bite people. If it is that you come in the house or in the space or in his space particularly, without saying, you know what they do with dogs, and you put your hand to their nose and they smell, and you know be all friendly. If they don't like you, I mean, it's your fault. But there was an incident where they had killed my dog in the middle of the night. And I woke up and he was just like completely still and swollen. They poisoned my dog. Yeah. Still haven't gotten over it, because I had that dog since he was a puppy. So he was well trained, like really, really well trained.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
That's my stuff, man.
It is.
Mm-hmm. All right, so this is a dumb question, but all right, so do you guys have a Walmart in Jamaica?
We have something like a Walmart.
What is it called?
We call it Sovereign, I guess, because it has everything there. It has food in there. Well, it's mainly like a chain of restaurants or places in one area. So there's KFC, Burger King, there's Pizza Hut, there's Domino's, then there's a couple of pharmacies, then there's outdoor restaurants where you can actually eat outside, there's supermarkets there. There's just a chain of places in one specific area.
That's cool. That's cool. Do you guys have any malls that, like, if that's in America, we would call that like a mall, probably. Do you have?
Yeah,
any?
We have it here. Yeah.
That's cool. That's cool. That's cool.
I think there's one in every parish, if I'm not mistaken. I think, well, I think there's one in every parish.
That's cool. That's cool. That's cool. My next question for you, Miss Anita, is what are your 5 favorite drinks?
Grape soda. Coffee. Water. Did I say grape soda? Can I say grape soda again?
Absolutely. You said grape soda, coffee, water, grape soda again.
Mm-hmm. And grape soda. There you go.
Absolutely. Well, I know where to get you if I ever get you anything.
Grape soda.
That's cool. Do you like to go shopping?
For groceries? Yeah. Apart from that, not really. I like to go shopping for fabric. Is that called?
What are your 5 favorite stores to go shopping at?
Things, Pablo's, because they're all fabric stores. Trimmings World, Trimmings Galore. And the supermarket.
That's cool. That's cool. That's cool. Ain't nothing wrong with that. My next question for you is, what are your plans for the... I'm going to ask you these 2 back-to-back because they go together. The first one is, what are your plans for the next 5 years? And then my second question is, what are your plans for the next 10 years? Before you answer this, I just want you to know, I'm about to ask you a little... Those questions I just asked you, those are like the easy warm-up questions. The questions I'm about to ask you from now on out are going to be a little bit more difficult. You don't have to answer all of them if you don't want to. And also, if you... You don't have to talk long about them if you don't want to, or you don't have to talk short about them if you don't want to. There's no wrong answer. It's just however you want to say it, you can. I just want you to know.
All right. So so you said next 5 years and next 10 years, right?
Yes, ma'am. All
right. Next 5 years, I definitely want to own a store or a boutique because Darisha and I, as I said, we're business partners, and she has her own line, I have my own line. The plan or the aim for me is to really open up something that people can actually see me for who I am as a designer, or see things from my perspective. So yeah, that would be the business aspect of it. Definitely have a family, like, no questions asked about that. I definitely want to have a family so that would be the next 5 years. 10 years would be to Paris Fashion Week or New York Fashion Week. I have to. But in the span of those 10 years, that's what I would focus on. And in the span of the 5 years, that's what the aim would be.
Yes, ma'am. Do you have any special talents?
I sing. I do a lot of writing, poetry. Currently working on a book.
That's cool.
Yeah. It's been something that I always wanted to do. So, you know, during COVID, quarantine, lockdown, everything, I just decided to, you know, step back and focus mainly on the book. I have covered everything already. I started typing. I think I'm at chapter 5. So I want to have at least 10 to 12 chapters in. So,
yes, ma'am.
So it's singing and writing. Yeah, that's true.
Yes, ma'am. My next question I'm about to ask you, I'm going to ask the two back to back again because they go together. The first one is, what is your message to the girls of the future who are 20 years or younger? My second question for you is, what is your message to the women of the future who are 20 years and older?
All right, 20 years and younger. It's hard. I know because I've been there. There are going to be a few people who think that what you're doing or what your dream is going to be either, to them it's going to be stupid, or they're always going to have an opinion on what you're going to do. Don't listen to them. You focus on your dream, even if it is that you want to run a restaurant or have a truck or anything. Once it is that you put that hard work in, and you see yourself doing it, there is no stupid dream, there is no unnecessary thing that you can do to help yourself get where you need to go. That's the main thing. So the ones that are 20 and older, because I'm still in that batch, help those who are in need, who are younger than you, or who have not been in that situation before, because that's one of my biggest pet peeves. People who have the knowledge and refuse, and I mean really refuse, to help those who they see that really need the help. Because as I said, each one teach one, and once we teach them, they themselves can go out there and become a better person, and they themselves who become a better person can make the world a better place. So
yes, ma'am. Absolutely. Those are perfect answers. My next question for you, I'm going to ask these three back to back so you get a better understanding. The first one is, what would you tell your future self 20 years from now? The second one is, what would you tell your future husband 20 years from now? And then what would you tell your future children 20 years from now?
All right. So future self 20 years from now. Everything that you were so afraid of, it'll make sense in the long run. Future husband is currently watching football right now. And future children, work smart, not hard. That's one of the codes that I live by. Work smart and not hard. So, yeah. Yeah, that would be it.
Yes, ma'am. What is your message to all the women around the world?
My message to all the women around the world. Female empowerment is so important, especially if there is no female in your life who influences you. For me, growing up, I had my mom, my grandmothers actually, aunts, all of them who influenced me in a both positive and a negative way. Why I say negative is that the things that they did growing up, I won't lie, a couple of them influenced me in a very bad way. And I stopped and I asked myself one specific question, is this the life that you want to live just because they lived it? And my answer to that was, they lived their life. Why force me to not live mine? Women are so caught up with trying to create this image of what they see on TV, of being a boss lady. Not saying that's a bad thing, but show people out there that being a boss lady, one, it comes with hard work. Two, it comes with failing a lot. Three, it is worth it in the long run. Don't let it seem as if, you know, you wake up one day and you find $1 million at your doorstep and all of a sudden you're a boss lady. Let them know that you work so hard, you're putting a lot of hard work. There are times when it's going to seem as if you can't anymore. Find people out there that influence you in the most positive way ever. Even if you don't have those persons, influence yourself, because that's important. That's really important. Self-influence or self-positivity is really, really important. And I think that's a lot of things that I'm not seeing happening in this day and age or in this time. The generations to come need to understand that both male and female, we have to work together and not think that, oh, you know, women have to do everything on their own because this is how society made it feel. So,
yes, ma'am. Yeah. Are there any shout outs that you would like to make to your friends or to your family?
First, I want to shout out to myself. This year, 2020, it has been. And I know everybody is going through the same thing, but this year I really proved to myself that as an entrepreneur, it's not easy. I mean, I used to sit down and look at everyone's Instagram page and go, oh, I want to get there. But I never stopped to thank myself or, you know, pat myself on the shoulder to say, hey, you know when you started? And who knew 5 years from now you'd be here? So I just want to, you know, pat myself on the shoulder and say, that's all for you. You did really good. Second of all, he's watching football, he probably can't hear me. My fiance / husband to be, he has been my rock for so long. Sometimes I don't know how he does it, but he does. He does. Get you a strong partner, guys. Like, and stop making it seem as if men are so difficult to handle. There are some really great guys out there who just want to, you know, empower us as women. So yeah, shout out to him, shout out to Darisha, my business partner. Like, you have taken me from here to all the way up here with just one introduction. So I thank her for that. All my best friends who have always been supporting me. I can't even list anybody names because if I meet one person, they're gonna cuss me out.
Yeah, don't cuss her out. Don't cuss her out. Don't cuss her out.
They will. Yeah, so my best friends have been very supportive of me. My family, who has been my backbone through thick and thin, especially my cousin Chrissy. She's like my twin, like literally. If you see her, you see me. If you see me, you see her. I call her my alter ego because she's a very blunt part of me. If I'm afraid to say something, she'll go, oh, I got you. And she'll just let it out. And that's one of the things I love about her. When she's ready, she's very soft. But that's creepy for you. All my friends who have been very supportive of me. It's been a very bumpy ride, but, you know, that's how dreams are made. What, yes, so is diamonds. They're made under pressure. So, hey, why not?
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely.
And to my kids, for the future, when you see this, you'll understand why mommy did all of this for you.
That's cool. are there any nicknames that you would like to shout out? Like, some people say, like, shout out Kiki, shout out JJ, shout out Marco, you know? If you don't have any, it's okay.
No.
Okay, that's cool. What did your parents teach you as a child that you would like to teach your children in the future?
Oh God, what's that thing? I mean, that one thing my mother always tell me. Oh my. If you have nothing good to say, don't say it. That's one. That's very key in Jamaican culture. Two, if you don't like when someone else does it, do it yourself. Or if you don't like how they do it yourself in terms of favors and support. Three, never ever settle for less. Don't let anyone tell you that, oh, you're small and you won't make it because your dreams or, you know, your aspirations, they sound silly. If I had to count how many times I heard that from people, I wouldn't have been where I am now. If I had listened to them, I wouldn't have been where I am now.
Yes, ma'am. Miss Anita, my next question is, what would you like people to know about you before they go to your social media?
I am a fun and loving person. Really, I am. I might have that face that you think that, oh, I don't want to talk to her because she seems or she looks this way. Assumptions are never right about me. Like, ever write about me. So, I mean, be respectful. That's one of the most important things when it comes to me. You respect me, I respect you. And that goes a long way.
Yes, ma'am. Would you like to talk about your social medias?
Sure. I have three Instagram pages.
You have three?
I'm going to explain why.
How you keep up with that?
I don't know. The first one is a personal page, but it's private because I keep my life very private. The second one is the Naomi Avec Amour. That's the fashion page. The third one is the partnership between me and Miss Derry. So that one is Melanique Amour. I can send you that one it's tagged on my business page. It's all over my business page. So yeah, that's three of them. How I manage all three, I don't know. I really don't know. It's something from college, multitasking. Time management, all of that. I suck at that, I won't lie, but when it comes to like the business aspect of me, I don't know. It just works.
Absolutely. All right. So how do you feel women are represented in the world?
That is an excellent question. How do I feel women are represented in the world? It's a 50-50 thing to say, because as I said before, you know, I'm going to give an example, like models, right? People think that models are supposed to be slim, they're supposed to be tall. If you have a little fat, you can't be a model, and so forth. It's the same thing when it comes to females. People are going to generalize females as, oh, you know, she's this or she's that. And in a sense, social media plays a really, really important part in that. Because you have women out there who put themselves out there because they want people to like them, or they want to, you know, uphold a certain image, when you also have people out there who just remain true to themselves, and they're either bashed for not being this kind of female, or not wanting to go out, or not wanting to do the certain things that other females do. And when they do that, they're bashed with negativity. So it's a whole 50-50 thing. It's either you're genuinely yourself, or you just want to uphold that image, and you feel okay with upholding that image for the rest of your life. I mean, problem, that's not new.
Yes, ma'am. What do you think needs to change for women to have more power?
They need to change themselves. That's quite blunt. They need to change themselves. Stop thinking that men owe us everything. Stop thinking that people in general owe us everything. You can't expect to get somewhere without starting. Full stop. For us to have that power that we need to have as women, as females, we have to rise up and rise above that stigma that, oh, you know, women are supposed to be at home taking care of the kids. That's fine. That's okay if you want to do that. But show your kids that even if you're a stay-at-home mom, you run a business at the same time. Even if it is that you like to, you know, sell beauty products, show them how it's done, how it's okay to be an entrepreneur who is a stay-at-home mom. Don't let them think that, oh, my mom's not working this big-time job because she doesn't dress up and go out. I mean, children live as they learn. So if they see that happening, they're going to want that too.
Yes, ma'am. All right, so I have like 3 more questions for you. 3 or 4. The next question I have is for the African community, of everybody of color. My first one is, could you send a positive message to our brothers and to our sisters on coming together instead of going different ways, if that makes sense? If you don't understand, I'll explain it better.
Sure, explain.
I don't know about Jamaica, but here it's like we have a lot of black people who come together, who love each other, and who will try to help out anybody. But we also have some black people who, because of their environments, because of their situations, they tend to like be divided. As in like, oh, I don't like you, so I ain't about to be cool with you, or I don't like the way you look, I don't like the way you dress, or whatever. Like, can you send a positive message trying to bring everybody together?
And that's a very touchy topic as well, because with all that's happening in America and in Africa and in Nigeria specifically, with the whole racism and all of that, it really hurts, because I mean, we're all human. We're all the same. And if I'm climbing a ladder and I see my brother sliding down, I have only one option, to help him up. We're all going to the same place at the end of the day when we die. We're all going the same place. We're going 6 feet under. So, in a sense, what I'm trying to say is us coming together as a race will show everyone out there that regardless of what you say about our skin color, regardless of what you say about our hair, regardless of what you say about who we are, who you think we are, us coming together and showing them we're nothing like that, we'll let them stop and say, hey, you know, I was wrong about you. How is it that I can help you or help your community to get where you need to go? And it's something I've seen happening a lot, because it does happen in Jamaica. You do have a few people here who, whether you're family or friends, and, you know, because you're not, I mean, you are black, but if you're not light-skinned black, they go, oh, I don't think I want to help this person because I don't see them going anywhere in life, or so forth and so forth. We're all the same race. So put aside your differences, put aside the anger, the frustration, and stop and realize we are all the same race. And at the end of the day, we're all human beings.
Absolutely. How do you feel Black women are represented in the world?
We are represented poorly. Why I say that, recently I found out that a few of the hair care products, like, for instance, Shea Butter and so forth, just an example, it's not owned by Black people, it's actually owned by white people or white men who feel the need to tell Black women how their hair should look. And they basically put us in this box to say, this is the image of how a woman or a Black woman should look. And a lot of people, or a lot of females, buy into that to say, oh, they want, and it plays an important part with also jobs. So we are represented poorly, and that's the main thing why women are becoming entrepreneurs right now. Because one, they can't get a job because of how they look or their education. So they say, hey, you know what? I love cooking. I'm going to become a chef. They still get, as we Jamaican call, FICO, because you're Black, you own a restaurant, and they don't want to come there because you're Black. So, and a lot of people get discouraged because of that. A lot of them will say, oh, you know, maybe I should have give it up because no one will come to my restaurant. Listen, if it's just one or two persons coming to your restaurant, let those one or two persons be your go-to, your motivation to say, you know, some people out there, they actually like what I'm doing. Maybe I'm influencing them or showing them to say, hey, regardless of anything, do what you dream of doing. Serious. Full stop. So, us as Black women, we really need to understand that, yes, we're represented poorly, but how can we change that from happening again, or to the next generation, per se?
Yes, ma'am. My next question for you is, what is your message to the Black women of the world?
My message to the Black women of the world, help your sisters, help your Black sisters, because, I mean, we're all trying in this day and age. It's so frustrating sometimes when I see women tear each other down, especially Black women, and I'm like, why would you do that? You've been in this situation before. And that's the thing, some people, they forget where they're coming from because they're so focused on where they are. No. So I think that would be my biggest message, you know, help each other out, help your sister out. We're all trying.
Yes, ma'am. Could you talk about your hair?
Hi.
Yeah. What do you call it? What do you call it?
We call it locks.
Would you talk about your locks?
Sure. I was in college and I had permed my hair, or what as Jamaicans call it, cream our hair. And I was going through a really bad phase, I won't lie. And it was fourth, it was finally, and it was stressing. And I was like, you know, I think it's time for me to take a walk down back that natural journey. And I had cut my hair off. I mean, it was super short. And I think that's when I really decided to be committed to something. And I grew it for like 3 years. And I started doing research into locks, like, what are the advantages, what are the disadvantages, you know, what to not use in it here, what to use in it. So I did a full-on research And I had called up a friend of mine, Aeon, who is my loctician. And I was like, hey, you know, could you start my lock for me? And he, of course, he asked, are you sure you want to do this? Because, you know, it's lock. How I do it or how he does it, he locks it to the point where you can't pull it out. So it's like, all right, I don't mind because I don't intend on pulling it out. Why start something and then pull it out? Like, does it make any sense? Unless it is that you have a hair issue or it's falling out or something, that's fine. So I've been locked for 5 years. And my hair is so long. Sometimes I don't know what to do with it. I mean, and it grows so fast because of the things that I use. Like, it's strictly natural products in my hair. I don't use, like, certain oils, and then the worst thing is that I have eczema. So my hair has to be oiled every other day. My hair also has to have water-based oil. There are certain oils I can't use because my eczema will act up. As I said, it's a whole lot. But it's worth it because I actually influenced 5 people to lock their hair.
That's cool.
Because they keep asking, will it go through that? Because it went through a budding stage where it was horrible. But I kept pushing. I kept going with it. And as I said,
is that your fiance? Tell him I said hey.
Alex. He says hi. But yeah, that's my lock journey. It's all blue, by the way. I've went through pink, red, purple, pink, red, purple, green. Then red again. No, I went through 6 colors.
That's so cool. That's cool.
6 colors. Because I found a way to lighten the color to add another one to it. Apple cider vinegar and baking soda. That works magic. And it also detoxes your hair as well.
What's your next color you plan on getting after blue?
I never know until my birthday. Literally, every year for my birthday, I change color.
That's cool. All right, so what are some tips for people who have locks in their heads that you would like to give?
I know, like, some people, they go to, like, the salons and they use certain products in their hair. Bring your own product. Like, that buildup is not nice. It's horrible. Bring your own oil for your own shampoo, because there are certain shampoos that you can't use if you have some kind of hair. Like, for me, as I said, I have eczema. And I use the Tresemme and
Tresemme not for us. It's not for us.
You know what I mean?
It's not for us. No.
It makes your hair hella dry.
For real. It makes your scalp dry.
Yes. like just invest in the natural product. Like, tea tree oil is amazing. Rose water, you can actually get roses, boil the petals, and add your essential oil to it, and you get your own rose water. Just research, like, really. Don't go like your hair and then cut it off back because it's not good. Research, please.
How often do you wash your hair?
Every week, because I have really bad eczema.
Absolutely. All right, so those last questions, all right, so all the questions I've been asking you were for everybody else. Those questions was for me. Cause, you know, I don't know. I don't talk to too many people with locks.
Okay.
I don't talk to nobody with locks from Jamaica. You the first one. But I had to ask you, you know? That's cool. That's cool. All right, so, Miss Anita, my last question for you today is, what would you do if you were the president?
I'm always asked this question. I don't know why. I would just, for one day, would it be for like one day or just overall if I was the president for like 4 years?
Yeah. For 100 years, what would you do? Yeah. President for 100 years.
The most important thing I would do is to always remember that I'm a human being and so is everybody else. I mean, it's not like I'm a robot and everyone else is just robots who don't work properly or software. The one thing that I know I would do, I would make it my point of duty to, you know, take a walk in some of the communities, you know, find out what are their budding issues, how is it that I can help, make their situation better. Education is like the biggest thing, especially now. I'll teach them a skill or ensure that each school teaches a child a skill. Because people are always saying, oh, they want their child to be a doctor, lawyer, nurse, teacher. But what about if they don't have that? Teach them a skill. And I think that's how I came by doing this, because I was taught a skill since I was a child. What else I would do? I wouldn't focus mainly on the negative things all the time, like what presidents and prime ministers do. I, you know, say for instance, 12 o'clock every day, I come on the news or support and I'm like, hey guys, today I got a letter from someone and they were just, you know, emailing me to say support and support. What do you think are the things that we can do to help this person? You know, basically to make the country a better place and stop focusing on you being a president or you being a leader. Set down the notch for a while and just step into other people's shoes and find out what their issues are. But yeah.
Yes, ma'am. All right, so Miss Anita, that's my interview. I appreciate you coming on my I got one more question. I got one more. Is there anything that I left out or anything that I didn't ask that you would like to talk about?
Goodness. No, you practically covered every aspect that needed to be covered and needed to be said, to be honest. Because when Derry told me what you were doing, I was like, so hook a girl up, because this is something. And when she told me that you were a guy, I was surprised. I was like, that's strange. This is something that we should be getting from females. But then I wanted to do it because I needed other people to know around the world that there are other entrepreneurs out there, and regardless of where you are in the world, Europe, Asia, Africa, we're all one in the same. We're all trying to fight that battle of being an entrepreneur so that our kids can come along to say, all right, you know, mommy built a dynasty for us, daddy did this, they work together as a team. And, you know, here we are now. So I really appreciate what you're doing, and I really do hope and pray that it goes a long, long, long way. Even though you said you've been doing this for 3 weeks, you've got a lot of interviews. And that's really, really good. A lot of people look at it and say, oh, you know, he just wants to, you know, talk to females. And that's in his thing, like, what? Why would people say that? You're doing something really, really important. You're trying to empower black females or black entrepreneurs, and that's something that I've never seen anyone else do other than a female. So my hat's off to you for doing that.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you again, Miss Anita. When I post this, if you like it, in the future we can do a part two, part three, part four. It don't matter. I'm all for it. Thank you again, Miss Anita. If y'all don't like my channel, it's okay. It's not for me. It's for them. So even if you don't like me, go check her out. I'm going to have all her stuff.
Definitely be sharing this. Like, no questions asked. Definitely. And if I have anyone else, I will send you their contact information as well so that they can, you know, spread the word.
Please do. Please do. I'll tell you why after this interview. But yeah, please. Thank you, Miss Anita.
You're welcome.
Thank you.